Very well. So here we are. So we can see the, she's talking about each one of these over here are planets. There's the sun right there. The circle with the dot in the middle of the sun is the sun. And then these right here tell us the degrees that the planets are in the sign. So for instance, let's do this. For instance, this sign right here is 30 degrees. So in the middle would be 15 degrees. That would be like cutting the pizza. 15 degrees. So this planet right here is at 21 degrees, we can see. 21 degrees. Remember, right here is 15. There's an arrow right there. That's 15 degrees right there. So, Fifteen, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. Over here would be 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8. So in between this slice right here is 7.5 degrees. That's exact center. So we just call it 8. 8 degrees. It would be the center there. So let's, we'll clear that. So this planet right here is 21 degrees inside this pizza slice. It's a pizza slice right here. Slice of the pie. Some people call this the zodiac sign. Now, this piece of slice right here, from here to here, we have the sun at 14 degrees. Now you have to figure there's one planet here in it, two planets here, here's the sun, here's another planet, and here's another planet. We have all those planets right there. All these planets right here in this one zodiac sign right here. They call this the 12th house. House number 12. Because there's 12 zodiac signs. So they're all bunched up right there. Now, to get a big picture of how this is, this right here is the Earth, right in the middle. This is planet Earth, the E. Now, the Sun is out here. Okay. See, there's the sun. So planet Earth is looking at the sun right here. See? And here's the moon right here. Okay. So the moon is in the back of the Earth. While everyone is having sunshine over here during the day. See that? The moon is on the other side of the Earth, just opposite the sun. So as the sun rotates, or the Earth rotates around the sun, so to speak. Let's do it this way. Okay. Here's the sun out here. Here's the Earth. Call that the Earth. And the moon is out here. It's a three-quarter crescent. So, as the Earth is spinning counterclockwise, the Earth spins this way. And the Earth is also traveling this way. The Earth is performing two functions. So, when we say the Earth is traveling that way, we're meaning it's spinning this way. And if we also take this and just say counterclockwise, it's actually traveling around the sun this way. Around the sun. So the Earth is moving this way counterclockwise. Around this sun. So, let's do this again. Here's the sun. Little dot in the middle. This is the Earth, right in the middle of the pizza pie. This circle right there. Here's the moon. Okay, so the sun is traveling counterclockwise, or the Earth is traveling counterclockwise around the sun. Also, the Earth spins counterclockwise. It's spinning this way. Like a top. The moon is also traveling counterclockwise. Now, I'm going to show it. We're going to look. We're going to prove this. I'll show you. I'll show you how it works. We're going to go to a website. Whoops, let's close this out. We have another web page. Moon phases calendar. This is it right here. Livevisions.com. This is Live Visions, and we go to current transit right there. So tap on current transit and solar system. scope. Waiting for this to see here. Here we are. I think we have to click on this. This is a website that has a live movements of the planets. It used to just fire. It usually starts right up. Let's do this again. Eyes of the Universe. Let's check Eyes of the Universe. This might be. Nope, that wasn't it. Well, let's look at Eyes of the Universe. Let's see if this one was it. Solar system. Look at this one. No. It was the first one. It was this one, solar system scope. This tells us where all the planets are. Let's look at this a little bit. See if she has the symbols here. No. Okay, let's go back. And solar system. We're going to shut this other video over here. This is we're recording everything here. I'll stop recording on this YouTube video. It's working pretty good. And see if that'll speed things up. And let's look at the upload video upload page. See how everything's. There's that. Hold on, I'm gonna go over this other one. We'll publish this one. This should be upload right here. See where it went. Video duplicated already. Oh, all right. So that was number 5. Let's do number 6 then. We're multitasking right here. We'll upload another video. and YouTubes here. Movie. YouTubes. Desktop. Yeah, there we are. Video 6. There we are. Let's put a thumbnail on this while we're here. And pictures. We'll put goats. Been doing goat pictures here. Put that one, goats, right there. There we are. Oh, it's almost already finished. This video was rejected. Yeah, alright. Let's, hold on. Let's publish it anyway. Valid request. So let's look at the video and figure out. Desktop. Let's change the format on it. That usually helps out. Make it an MP4. Whoop. Lowercase p. Lowercase. There we are. Let's try that. See how that is. Video 6. Let's see how that one. Then we'll put another custom thumbnail on that. Pictures. Goats. Horn goats. There we are. Duplicate. Oh, so that one's a good duplicate. Let's go to number 7 then. Desktop. 7. And put a thumbnail on that one. Pictures. Goats. Let's put goats here. Horn goats, and there we are. Very well. Doodle-doo. And let's do this. I'm gonna make a thing over here. For the where is it at? Well, let's make another one. Let's try that. Says that one's already there. Right, let's see where it's at. Oh, it must be up top. There it is. Alright. We'll take these. Put them up here. Into that. Beautiful. Now, we're good. that's uploading. Now let's get back to the solar system. We're going to look at the planets. Ah, here we are. There we are. All right. Now, this is a wonderful universal picture. So over here, right, so here we see the planets. Well, let's heliocentric. Let's try a geocentric view. Okay, the geocentric is the Earth. Right, here we are. Then we slide over to the scale over here. And we can get closer. Okay, and then double click the screen. Oh, press start. There we are. Okay, so let's get the pen. See the Earth right here? This is the Earth. It's traveling counterclockwise around the Sun. See the Moon? The Moon also travels counterclockwise around the Sun. See that? This is Saturn. Saturn moves slow because it takes 30 years to move around the Sun. The Earth, it takes 1 year to move around the Sun. Now all we have to do is just hold our mouse or pointer, click on it. Oop. We have to quit highlighter before we can do that. This is Venus. See that? See the little Venus? This is Venus. This right here is Mercury. This right here is Mars. Okay. Now, let's go back to the YouTube. So, all these... Now, let's get our highlighter again. Here's the Earth. Here's the Sun over here again. And here's the Moon. It's over here. Represented this right here. All I did is I just moved the Sun over here. So the moon right here is traveling around the Earth. This is E. It's the Earth. And the Earth is headed counterclockwise. So is the Moon. And all I did was I just put a big moon out here on the side. So. So actually, let's just go with the chart. Let's say this is the Sun, and the Earth is right here. And here's the Moon over here. For the sake of the charts, however, the Moon is actually right here. And the Moon is traveling around the Sun, like that, counterclockwise. And the Earth is traveling around the Sun. Circle. See how that is? So, all these planets right here, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and here's 8, and here's 9. Here's a planet here. There's actually 9 planets. Some of these might not be planets in there. I'm still learning these symbols. However, in the perspective of things, if the Earth is in the center here, a little circle, and the 3/4 moon is turning around the Earth, and both of these are turning around the sun counterclockwise this way, that means all these other planets are also turning counterclockwise around the sun. There's a planet, there's another planet there, here's another planet, it's turning around the sun, and this one over here, this symbol right there, is another planet. All these planets are turning around the sun. Let's go back to the solar system. See that? They're all turning or moving around the sun. So, what this YouTuber is saying, she's saying all the planets are congregated right here. They're all congregating. See that? Because it takes these planets, the Earth, it takes a whole year for the Earth and the Moon to travel around the Sun. See that? So, the Earth is standing still, not standing still, but it's taking its time traveling 365 days. So, this is a speeded up version of time right here. If you look down here at the bottom right here, we have July. Now we moved into August. The 13th, 15, 17, 20, 21, 23, 24, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 1, 2. Now we're in the month of September. Takes 12 months for the planet, the Earth, to move. However, this planet right here, it's closer to the sun and it has less distance to travel around the sun. So it takes 88 days to move around the sun. And this planet right here, it takes a little bit less. You can see that this planet right here, it's moving faster. Right here, we'll just follow it around. See how fast it's moving? It'll actually catch up to this planet over here. This one's moving a little slower. This one right here is moving a little slower too. See? Takes longer. Here's the Earth again. So, here's Jupiter over here. And it takes a long time to move around the sun. It moves slowly. However, the idea in the charts is that all the planets are hanging out over here. Most of the planets are on one side of the universe right now, or one side of the sun. See that? Now let's go back to the video and we can see it. That's what she's saying. So, see? They're all over here. Although some of these planets are move faster than the others. Here's the Earth again. The Earth is over here. Yet all these planets, we'll just draw the circles. And you have to realize these planets are all in their own circle orbits. This one's in a big circle. This one would be in a closer circle. And this one would be in its own circle. Just like when we go back. They're all in their own circle around the sun. So when we go back here, here's the sun right here. However, for the sake of putting everything on a chart, an easy chart to read, they just line them all up just like that. However, it's our third eye which sees the invisible, which puts perspective on everything. We see that the planets are all in their own little course around the sun. Here's the sun right here. All these planets are revolving around the sun. So, but you notice they're all pretty much, otherwise, let's say this, otherwise, another option, say this planet right here, it could be over here. And there is a planet right there. Here's one planet over here. It's over here on this side. Further away from the sun. Here's the sun. So. That's how we read these charts. And then she gives her interpretation. She's telling her story. This is her story of why these planets are all congregated over here around the sun, close to the sun. That's her story. And it's the popular story of horoscopes and astrology, which everyone has come to accept for the sake of unity. However, there is a higher level, and that's where we create a story for the path of our life. And another thing that she says is that certain planets, say this one right here is at it says 15 degrees right here. That's a 15. Okay. Here's a planet right here. It's at 16 degrees. So, that's pretty much a straight line. 16, 6, and 15 are pretty much the same. So when she says in her video, it's a squared. It's squared off. A square is a straight line. A square is a straight line. Like that. Here's one that's at 12 degrees right here. So, it's still kind of pretty much. So this one's, we could say it's squared too, and this one's squared to that. So, and then we have the shape of a triangle. And the verbiage in astrology is they call it a trine. And if you have, when we're born, if we have planets that are lined up in triangles like this, the more that the planets are triangular, then according to this particular story of astrology, then a person has much more energy in his life. So sometimes you'll have planets that'll trine like that, and you'll have what's called a Star of David. These people have a particular energy, and you might even have have another triangle like this, and it will be three stars triangled. And we can also have situations where we have a triangle, 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 triangle like that, and they kind of overlap like that. I've seen some charts like that, or one chart like that. And this is, in the popular interpretation of astrology, this is very special. People that have this triangles like this, if they have three triangles like that, they're very energetic people. And they emit a large amount of energy that's very beneficial to society. So, now, let's listen to what she has to say.
And it is at 14, the sun is at 14 degrees of Aries, with the moon at 14 degrees of Libra. It is...
Okay, so she said the sun is at
14... Connected to the Uranus...
She said that the sun is at 14 degrees in Aries. So this pizza slice right here is Aries. This is the zodiac sign called Aries. And Aries is the ram. And the ram has the circular horns on his head. This would be a ram. This is his body. And here's his eye. And here's his mouth. That's a ram. And they might have a little tail. And if it's a male, he'll have a couple testicles down there. And he'll have a penis. And if it's a female, she'll have a vagina back here. And that's why she said the sun is in 14 degrees of the zodiac sign Aries. Now, remember, here's the Earth right here. The Earth is right in the middle. Now, when we say Aries, we're talking about, if, let's say for instance, we're on planet Earth right here. We'd be on the side of the planet right here. Here'd be the United States. And we're looking out toward the sun. Okay. Now, out here, there's stars out here, and they're positioned like such. And when we look out the side of the planet, go out in the backyard and we look into the sky and we see the sun back here, remember that the sun's shining so bright that we can't see the stars during the day, but behind it is what's called the zodiac constellation of Aries, or the ram, because when we do dot to dot, and that's what these astrologers do, they just connect the dots of the stars and they create the shape of a ram. These stars out here, here would be the tail. This demonstration that I'm drawing is not an exact replica of the stars of Aries. I'm still studying that. But, however, I understand the principles. So, that's why she says the sun is in 14 degrees of Aries. Because when we extend this out, the pizza extends out. All these pizza arms extend out. So all we have to do is, when the Earth comes around this way, it travels counterclockwise. If the United States is over in this side, then we'd be peeking out at the star constellations out here, and there would be stars out here, and they would be in the shape of the zodiac sign. So if this is Aries over here, this over here is going to be the sign of Leo. This is Leo the lion. And I know this because I've studied some charts to put them in my memories. This one over here is called Virgo. So, if we were to, if the Earth was on this side of the Earth right here as it's spinning around, or the United States, if it was over here, and we were going out in the backyard and looking at the stars at night, or during the day, however it would be, these stars out here, when they're, we'll just put some stars here. When we draw a little dot, the dots to them, okay, however the dots go, they form the picture of a lady. And we call this lady a virgin. And she has feet, legs. Here's her feet and her legs. Here's her arms. And here's her head up here. All these stars, there'll be probably a star down here where her feet is, and a star down here at her feet. And there'll be a star at her elbow. You know, wherever the stars are at, till such time as I study this and get the exact locations, here would be her breasts, her belly button, and an armpit over here, maybe an ear over here. So this would be the virgin. Okay. Now the next zodiac sign that we have stretched out here, this one over here is called Libra. This one down here is called Scorpio. S-C-O-R. This one over here, it's called Sagittarius, and it will have its own shape of stars. Now, this one down here is the sign of just playman, and that's Capricorn, C-A. That's the symbol of the goat. So, we'll put some horns on the goat's head here. That's just playman symbol. And the goat climbs the mountain. So we call it the mountain goat. And there's reasons behind that. When we study astrology, you'll understand, because Capricorn represents the month of January, and that's the cold month. So the mountain goat climbs up the mountain to get to the opposite pole where the sun would be. Up here represents the height of summer. This is called the top of the mountain. So all you have to do is just pretend there's a mountain up here. And that's called climbing the pyramid. And this is why Just Playman has had a lot of success climbing the pyramid of private maritime law, because the stars, the energy of the stars, according to one man's story, gives the sea goat, or the mountain goat, energy to climb up the mountain. Mountain goats are especially created to climb mountains. So we have a little bit of an understanding of the universe here in reading charts. So, once again, here's the solar system. And we can enlarge it, get a closer view. See that? See how bright the sun is? And we can bring it even closer and put the planets there closer. So now we see all the planets. This planet right here is Saturn. Hold on. The screen is pretending like it's in a spaceship. And so I had to click the screen to stop it. To stop the orbit of the spaceship. So here we are. This one over here is Uranus. This one's Saturn. This right here is the Sirius, the star. This is the second sun that's coming into our universe. This is what the Mayan shift has to do with. This star right here is heading this way. Actually, it's headed more like this way. And it circles like this. And this sun right here, it used to be way out here. But it's traveling this direction. And the two are going to circle each other around the Earth. And we're going to have a period of time where there's going to be two suns. Here would be the sun of Sirius, and here would be the sun of Earth. And we'll have 24 hours of sun, just about. And the Earth will be traveling around this sun right here. And this sun, this sun right here, will be, like I said, these two suns will circle each other. This sun is headed this way, like I said. This sun is headed this way. So actually, what they're going to do is they're going to circle each other right here. This would be more like what it looks like. They're going to circle each other. And of course, the Earth will be right in the middle here. So let's look at that again. These two stars are headed toward each other. It's called a binary. In the study of the stars, every star has a partner. And they circle around each other. One's a male star. One's a female star. So, I have to do more studies to find out which is the male, which is the female. And so, they do a dance. And they do what's called their orbit. When they circle around each other, they turn around each other right here. And this is what's called the golden age. There's going to be much more energy for the Earth. And so as this sun comes closer, the Earth is always traveling around the sun. And it will travel just like this, around the sun, as the sun makes its journey like that. The sun always travels around. And it continues to do that. That has been the predominant pattern that astrologers have figured out, those who have studied the stars in the sky. And however, just Playman, using the power of his thoughts, he's going to cause this to happen. He's going to cause these suns to continually stay in a circle right here for the rest of eternity. And we're going to have probably this bright star right here. It's going to come and join us so we can have three suns. We're going to have three suns in a circle right here. And keep in mind, everything in the universe is moving different, or has its own direction. So in all actuality, let's do this again. This sun right here, it's moving this way. It travels like this, and all the planets circle around it in a spiral as the sun is traveling through the universe. See how that? So if you can picture that in your mind. Although these two suns, let's do it this way. Let's say the sun is moving this way. So the planets are moving around the sun as the sun itself moves that way. And then this one is coming this way. So it has all of its planets too moving around it. If it has planets around it. So, yeah, we'll just say that. So this sun's actually moving this way. Yeah, we'll just stick with that presentation, that example. And this sun's moving this way. However, they're going to meet in the middle. And with the power of just plain man's thoughts, just plain man is going to have them stay right here in the middle. And they're both going to join each other. And this star called Sirius will change directions. And when it makes its circle right here, it'll circle with our sun right here. And instead of going this way, it will go this way in tandem with our sun that is also going this way. This is the power of thought that just play man is going to manifest and create the universe with agreement from all the creatures and all planets and all life. And we're gonna have a third sun join us. We're going to have three suns. It'll be a triangle, and the Earth will be in the middle. And of course, it will be rotating around the main sun. And these suns will also take their turns rotating around too. And this sun will also take its turn rotating around too. We're going to have three suns rotating around the Earth. And we can have even more than that. With the power of our thoughts, we can regulate everything. And we can regulate the temperature of the suns. So, it's called the Golden Age. So we put our pointer on the suns. Here's the sun right here. It gives the name of all the stars. So all we have to do is put a pointer on the stars. Every little star has a name. See that? And every planet has a name. There's Mercury. So we just keep the pointer on it as it flows. Here's Jupiter. Hi, June! June just popped up during Jupiter. Ah, little buddlet. So, gives us a little more knowledge of the sun. And so here we are. So there's that. And here's YouTube. That was a duplicate video, so let's mess around with the video. Let's listen to what the astrologer.
was exact just recently in March. And what this means is that this is a time where if relationships have not been brought back into balance, then the desire for individual freedom can shatter or shake things up. And this is not any new news, as the full moon in Virgo that we had in March 5th, Venus was at the same place, right? So here, the full moon in Virgo, March 5th, Uranus was at 14 degrees of Aries with Venus and square Pluto. And now, the lunar eclipse at 14 degrees of Aries, it's kicking that off. So whatever you came up in March around your relationships, around what wasn't working, what did work, this is a time, it's almost a little bit like a last chance energy to get it in balance. And it's not just romantic relationships, but of course that's the big one. It's relationships that you have in life with people that you care about, people that you value. And the North Node,
there's corporate relationships, banker relationships, job relationships, animal relationships, tree relationships, air relationships, star relationships.
In addition to this lunar eclipse around relationship patterns, it's also suggesting that wherever you have felt that things have not, you have not been thinking clearly, you think this way one day, that way the other day, just let it go. Just let your mind go to a state of like the black hole, where you can settle, clean slate, to find that sense of balance. In your own personal chart, what you want to do is you want to look and see where...
Now, the thing that she's saying is that, according to this one man's story of astrology, the planets give certain energies, and it can cause us people with our brains to think one way one day and think another way another day. And so she tells us this because we can prepare and put our thoughts, the power of our thoughts, to realize what energy is going to happen in a particular day. So we can prepare for it and use our thoughts to bring healing and health into our day.
Where the eclipse is happening, the sun energy versus the moon energy, and find that balance in your life in those areas of life.
Now, the reason why why a planet has a particular energy, and we'll outline this, is because here's the sun, and the sun has what's called sun rays, and this is electrical energy, and it bounces off these planets and comes back to the Earth. So it bounces off the moon, and those sun rays give energy to the Earth. It bounces off the planet Jupiter, and those sun rays, called reflections, reflecting the light, give a certain energy to the Earth. And the particular energy that it gives is called the energy of salt. And salt has to do with the word salvation. And salvation has to do with our eternal life. Okay. So that if the reflection of these planets are providing an atmosphere of salt in our lives, and through studying these, we realize that we're not getting enough salt in our life, what we'll want to do is start taking cell salts. and it'll help to bring equilibrium and balance to our emotions to help us to bring healing into our life, the ultimate being eternal life, which has to do with the seven chakras moving up the spine, the root chakra, all the way up to what's called the left and the right brain, which is represented by the two serpents that are intertwining up the medical symbol called the caduceus. And when they get to the top, when we properly activate the root chakra and send the oil back up the spine, it gets to the third eye, the hypothalamus, and it creates what's called manna, or eternal oil. And it comes down, and that manna activates all the dormant, the cells in our brain that are waiting to be activated. However, it takes salt to do this. Salt energy. So, all this astrology at its heart is actually telling us that the sun's rays reflecting off the planets is creating salt in the atmosphere. It's salt energy. And every one of these planets reflects back to us a particular salt. One of the salts is called caliphosphate. Another salt is called Himalayan sea salt. And there's 12 different salts. And this has to do with the 12 zodiacs. So that when a planet is in a particular zodiac sign, as it rotates around the sun, then it provides a certain salt in the atmosphere because of the reflection of the light, the vitamin D of the light, and all the electrical and magnetic energy that reflects back. Reflecting back is magnetic energy. The reflection of the sun going toward the planet is called electrical energy, and it creates salt in the atmosphere. Our bodies are made up of salt, and salt is the essence of electricity and magnetism. So, let's go back to listen to what she has to say. That's why, that's the heart of astrology. And then, of course, you know, one man has put his story on that. And explained and called all these signs, Virgo, one's Libra, one's this, and one's this. But most of the astrologers, they just understand to call it energy. Until they get to the point of more study, then they'll realize, oh, it's actually salt. That's what it is. It's the salts. Oh. All right. So let's listen to the lady some more.
My name's Donna Page.
Oh, that's the end of the video. So, that's that. Check our YouTube video. That one was a duplicate. Okay, let's get one last view of the solar system here. Let's see if we can. There we are. See if we can get that to. So now we're zooming out. All the planets. And that's as far zoomed out as it is. And we zoom back the other way. And we can see it get closer and closer. And closer. So we can just have the sun. Wah! And you can see down at the bottom, we're at September 1989. And this clock down here is programmable. So you can set it to any date you want, and then hit start, and it will start start the process. And you can go backwards in time, and you can go forward in time, just by pressing the buttons down here at the bottom. Here's past. It says backwards, past backwards. So you can see. Let's see here. Let's hit. Maybe we're supposed to hit start. It says past backward in time. So we press on that, and then hit start. That might be it. Nope. See if we can get this to go backwards. November 23rd, 22nd. Yeah, now it's going backwards. So it looks like I have to hold it down. There we are. July, June. Now we're going. Now it's rotating backwards in time. So, all right. So we'll end this video, upload it, and enjoy.